this season. Can't reveal it. The key is to shake it with some love, man. Now. That's what separates it. You mix it all in, you mix stuff you just add, sitting up there. That's enough for two grown men to share right there.
And we came in here to try the fish hoagie, man. They got two types of fish hoagie. They got a regular fish hoagie, and we got the Muslim fish hoagie, which is something that's been created here, only here. Got the Muslim sauce on there. It's made differently. So
cheers.
Cheers to y'all, man. Let's try this out.
Let's go.
Hey.
Wow. This is a game changer. This is a game changer. Hey, what's going on, y'all? Thank you for joining me on another episode of JL Jupiter TV.
Sup?
Yeah, we here in Nicetown, Philadelphia, man. Back at it, you know. Appreciate everybody showing so much love and support. And we're just gonna keep this thing moving, man. On this episode, we're currently here on the corner of Germantown and Wingo Hocken. I always love saying that name, Wingo Hocken. But we're about to visit a place called Sister Muhammad's because we heard they got a fish hoagie.
And I heard it's official.
You know what I'm saying?
Official, man.
Fish hoagie. I love me a good fish hoagie. We just did an episode on a hoagie, but this time we're gonna switch it up and we're gonna do a fish hoagie, man. So let's go ahead and check it out. Do me a favor, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Let's go eat some good food.
I'm Ed, Sister Muhammad's, man. What can I say? We've been around since, 1999 as a restaurant. About 96, 95, we used to do bacon, bean pies, carrot cakes, banana puddings, and all of that previous to us opening a restaurant. Definition of a family business, man. Anybody that in our family that needed a job or couldn't provide or whatever the situation was came through Sister Mom's kitchen. So the fish hoagie is my mom's idea. Don't ask me what in the world made her ask. I don't know that process, but it's the biggest seller that we had. People love it. People come from all across the country to get it. Some people try to duplicate it, but they don't succeed too well. Muslim fish hoagie. That we got that recipe from Arthur Muhammad. He used to have a restaurant. He used to be one of our partners. He brought that recipe to the table, and we ran with it. They love that as well. If you asked me to make a choice, I would probably go fish hoagie just because it's not as many things in it. Muslim fish hoagie is very good, but you can't eat that on the run. You got to sit down and eat that.
Now, people want to know, do you have to be Muslim to order fish hoagie?
No, that's the joke of the century. Uh-huh. What is Muslim sauce? Why is it called Muslim sauce? I don't even know why it's called the Muslim sauce because I didn't create it. But no, you do not have to be Muslim to come get it. Process. Fish. It's pre-seasoned. Can't reveal the season, but it's pre-seasoned. So what we do, some people dip theirs in an egg-based batter. We don't dip it in the egg-based. We dip it in the milk base. Key is to shake it with some love, man. That's how you get the good tea.
Hello, P.E. Oh, okay. Yeah,
man. Key to not destroy your deep fryers and get as much of that flour off of there as you can.
This game right here, you're giving them too much game, man.
Oh, they need that. Save that $40, $50 for that oil. Thank you.
ketchup on tomatoes and onions.
Muslim is a standard way that we make it. And I'll break that process down for you. Onions. Sweet pepper. Bring the red pepper. Tomatoes. How's everybody doing? The ingredient is the raisin. That's what separates it. So while the fish is cooking, kind of dice that up. Mind you, you don't get this much in a regular hoagie, but I'm doing four of them, so. That's what you want, that golden brown, beautiful texture, beautiful color.
Is it being grilled too right now, or just put it on here?
I put it on here because that steam will melt your cheese. You can dice it up for the most
part. So the fish hoagie is whole?
Yeah, the regular fish hoagie is whole. The Muslim is diced up in the chunk, and you're mixing it all in your good stuff you just had sitting up here. Not a Muslim fish hoagie without Muslim sauce.
We got any more half of these pots of stuff?
You only got what you got out there? Gotcha.
Yeah, man, so we in here now. This place is spacious. You know what I mean? Got a lot of nice artwork on the wall. Definitely a Muslim place, so shout out to all my Muslim followers, man. Much love and respect to y'all. Let's get down on some Sister Muhammad's good food, you know what I mean?
That stuff should look so good, man. Prepare back there in Ephraim, man.
It's a fact, man. It was a pleasure watching Ed back there cook and breaking down the process of the difference between a fish hoagie and a Muslim fish hoagie. So, what do you want to get down on first?
Man, listen, man. Whatever went on top, I guess. You know what? Let's do the fish hoagie. Let's do the Muslim fish hoagie because that's different. Oh, you want the fish hoagie first?
It don't even matter. Alright, what's on top? Sorry about that.
You farted, man.
I don't even know which one this is. But,
Yes.
But do the reveal. I think this is the Muslim
one. Yeah, I think it is too.
Ooh. Let me tell you something. This can feed about two grown men or three people. This thing is massive, man. It's got, I already showed y'all the process, so the main difference between the fish hoagie and the Muslim fish hoagie, this one's chopped up. The other one is you get four slabs of fried whiting on there.
Also,
fresh fried whiting.
Also, it's chopped up, but it got the raisins in it.
That's right. Just, they got raisins in here, you know, all types
all
of
onions,
sweet peppers.
Green peppers and
yeah.
All that, all cooked on the grill.
Yeah.
Chopped up, cooked together.
So we about to do this. We're going to break this off. This is going to be our plate. Where you get down, brother?
Man, I was born ready, man.
All right. I love veggies, you know what I mean? More veggies, the better. You ready to do this?
Cheers.
Cheers to y'all,
cheers,
man.
Y'all.
Let's try this out.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Okay.
Wow.
All right, come on. Let's get it moving. Let's get it moving.
I don't want to be loud in here.
What information I got to get from y'all?
Look, I'm going to tag y'all.
Right. You already know the page already?
I'll find it. It ain't hard to find
what,
it.
Tag my... What?
Yeah, give him. This is the man that made it back here. We just took our first bite of the Muslim hoagie, bro. This thing is out of this world. This bangs right here, man. This is a game changer. This is a game changer.
You only gonna get that here.
Yeah. I've never had a fish hoagie like this ever in my life. Especially with that Muslim sauce too. I'm gonna do this again. Mm. Wow.
I'm gonna be loud, but I won't be loud in here, but I'm gonna be loud, yo. I'm gonna scream, I'm gonna shout. I'm gonna hear him from this bar and dance.
Why don't you? You know where you at, that's why. You a nice town, baby. You better act right.
Hey, they'll appreciate it, man.
Yeah, straight
up. They knew like I knew how good this was. They'd be up on the board dancing too. Dang, yo.
Sweet peppers, the pickles, the onions, oh. Green peppers, red peppers, all complement each other so well.
I'm not good.
That's the tag.
Oh, that's you? Okay. It's really not much to say. This Muslim fish hoagie bangs.
In the toss, man.
Banana pudding. Oh, man.
Look at this.
This. Oh, my goodness, man.
Banana pudding, too.
Damn, I hope to see y'all back like before the week is over.
We'll be back.
Oh, my goodness.
Appreciate y'all.
Thanks, Ed. So much love here, y'all. Great, great folks around here, you know what I mean? This is, out of this world. I want some more of that Muslim sauce in there.
I don't even talk right now, bro.
You don't talk in Egypt. There's a sandwich right here. You're gonna have to cancel all your plans afterwards. If you can eat a whole one by yourself, you're the man. Or the woman. Thoroughly impressed, man. Thoroughly impressed. This is...
I'm gonna get us some napkins, bro.
Oh, you do that. Thoroughly impressed. This is... I'm speechless. I'm ready to move on. How about you?
I'm born ready too.
Up next is the fish hoagie, regular fish hoagie. So the fish hoagies here are like their best sellers, man. I can totally see why.
I can see why. Mm-hmm.
This is, I have to say this is about 5 pounds.
So when you're making it, that thing was, that thing felt like an overgrown baby, man. Like,
you know what I mean?
Baby just came home. It's alright.
Alright, so we about to get down on the fish hoagie. Here's the reveal. Ooh. Ooh. You got 4 slabs of fried whiting on this hoagie.
I seen it.
We both seen it. And this, like I said, this right here, you can get whatever you want on it as far as topping goes or whatever it is. We chose to have them do the works on it. This has pretty much lettuce, tomato, onions, peppers. Mayo, salt, pepper. We told them to put the Muslim sauce on there, hot sauce, and ketchup on here. But if you're not really a saucy type of person, you can choose not to have no type of sauce, all right?
Well, this thing is heavy,
I'm not kidding you, man. This thing...
Even half of it, man. It feels like it's going to break this box.
It's a fact. Y'all see this? I don't know how I'm going to do this, but... Cheers.
Cheers,
cheers to y'all. Let's get down. One big bite. Mmm. Mmm. Can I get some slices of bread? Oh, man. Mm. You get to actually taste the fish on this one.
Oh, that's good. The fried
and that fish is flaky, it's hot.
Fresh.
That seasoning that they already have in there before it's
fried.
Before it's fried. Oh, you can taste that too. Mm. That is Man. That fish itself is freaking out of this world as well.
We're going to see you, the batter. This right here, what do you call this, my brother? This is a definite game
changer. Oh, they both game changers, that's for sure. You get your money's worth here, but at the same time, the flavor is here.
Look at that.
The value is here. The freshness is here. Highly recommended.
Yeah.
I'm gonna break a piece of this fish off so you guys can actually see. Oh, it's hot.
That's how you fry some fish.
That's still flaky as ever, dog.
Yo, he didn't just make that fish back there. He may love cooking that fish. Yo,
that's what he said. You gotta make love to it, man.
Yo.
Taste the fish by itself.
I get it already. But we're gonna do it again.
That fish itself is perfection. I'm gonna say it. This is probably the best fish hoagie I ever had in my life, man. There's no debating, you know? When it comes to freshness of it, seasoning, the amount you get, options, pricing, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So shout out to Sister Muhammad's Kitchen. Shout out to Ed for hooking it up, man. This is love right here. You can tell they cook with love here. Nice Town, where y'all at, man? Y'all got something. Y'all got a gem right here in Philly, man. If you in the surrounding areas, Philly, Jersey, Delaware, New York, this would definitely be worth the trip. This fish hoagie is slamming. To all my pescatarians, man, this episode is for y'all, man. Or vegetarians? Do vegetarians eat fish too? So Ed hooked it up before he left. He had to go leave. You know, I'm not so much of a sweet tooth person. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to give Miz the platform. He's going to judge it. I'm going to be in the camera too, but.
You know what I'm saying? Where I want to go? I want to go with the horse. Come on, man. You get the horse, man. Go ahead. You ready?
Let's go. Show the people.
Show them.
Big bite.
Oh, got strawberries in it too.
Strawberries at the bottom.
Oh, well, shucks.
Sure, strawberries or cherry?
They're strawberries.
Strawberries? All right, cheers.
Cheers, my brother.
Let's go.
First down, man.
What do you think, man? I think this is off the hook.
Yo. Ain't a first down. That's a touchdown, man. That's a
touchdown.
Look, he crossed the power line already. Touchdown. Yo.
After further review, we determined this is a touchdown. Banana Pudding had 2 feet in before going out of bounds.
No, they reached the ball on the nose of the ball, touched the pylon. Touchdown.
Yeah, man. So we're going to wrap this up. Appreciate you guys joining us on this episode. We'll see you on the next episode then. How about that? I need a nap.
Me too. My eyes is low right now.
Your eyes look like mine's.
Yo. You know what, man? Somebody told me, man, listen, man. They said, yo, are y'all real brothers? They said, because y'all kind of look alike. He's just like, he lighter than you. Y'all got the same shaped head. You know, I kind of took offense to that one, but.
You know, it's funny what they say. When you spend a lot of time with people, y'all actually start kind of like looking like each other. You know what I mean? You spend a lot of time with the sun.
Yeah. And, you know, you spend a lot of time with Jupiter.
We're going to wrap it up, y'all. Thank y'all for joining us. Make sure you subscribe. Follow the homie Juan Miz. Come to Sister Mama's Kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, man, eat some good food, man. I'll see you on the next episode. Peace.
Peace.